The old Arteza series. Today's Lemon Yellow, if I've read it right.
Arteza series.
Shut Still haven't really got the hang of Streamlabs. Like, I zoom it in, and then it'll just randomly zoom out again, but. What are you gonna do? It is lemon yellow, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Lemon yellow. Limon. We're nearly done with the yellows. Think. Are we? Yeah. Bumblebee yellow after this, and then we're onto sort of oranges and the darker colours. So this one and one more. Enough of that. Let's get to da. So I'm just gonna adjust the camera a little bit. Which again, I should have set up a little bit better than I have done, but I haven't, so what are you gonna do? I do wish I had slightly better equipment for this, but I don't. But that's why you keep grinding away to get more eyes on your work and all the stuff that comes with it. Right, let's crack on. Yellows was one of the colours that I was a bit worried about. Because against white paper, it doesn't show up as. As nice as other colours. I don't want to say it's nice, but. It's not as bright. But this one and the last one, the acid yellow one as well, showed up quite well. Yeah, like it doesn't look too bad. I think that's always the worry that you're not going to see it. I think the first one I did. The first couple was it pale peach, cantaloupe, and cream. I think those three were a little bit faint. I've mentioned before in a previous vid that there's a couple of pinks coming up. That you can see perfectly clearly on the tin, but on the paper, they're just non-existent. It just makes me think why. Why bother having it? Because it just wouldn't work at all in any drawing for anything. As a main part of your drawing, as a highlight, nothing. You wouldn't be able to see it. This is going to be a bit more of a freer sketch, like the ones I've been doing in my black book, because I haven't really got sort of any ideas. I have been working as been working quite hard sort of away from the streams and the cameras and stuff to improve my graffiti work. I did my first, well, not my first piece, but I did a piece yesterday trying to scale it a little bit back, trying to make the letters a bit more readable, and it's okay. I still need to think I need to work on the color selection a little bit. But I think when I get a little bit more confident in the letters, then I can start being a bit more brave with all the detail and stuff. I did get a very nice comment from N Diaz, his name, a graffiti artist I follow on Instagram. Someone who I'm a big fan of. Sorry, Diaz Zodiac. He's one of those artists that I love their work because it's like, again, it's really simple, but they still manage to make it look really detailed, and I'm always sort of jealous of that. I suppose jealous is the wrong word. I admire it, and it's I try and use their work as a inspiration to help me with my own work. Because I do think I can make it work, combining this style of art with graffiti. I do think there is something there. I've just got to figure it out. And like anything, it takes time, takes practice. You've got to put the work in. Still figuring out how to divide my time up. Disturb sign up. the sniffles. Right, where am I going to put the number this time? I think I'll keep it simple. I think I'll put it bottom right. I've got three folders dedicated to this series to fill. I think what we'll do is when I fill the first one, I'll do like a mini tour of like the progress. This is number 9. I have said before to get through the series quicker and just to be a bit more productive is that I'll try and start doing 2 every Friday. The only problem with that, it's not that I don't want to do it, because I do, but because there are, I think in addition to the series, the sort of series that I do at the minute, so the Monday stream kind of seems the least important, but or the more mess about one, but I think it's probably the most important one for me because it helps me sort of get into a rhythm for the week, and it's what I would do regardless anyway. I then do the time. I could probably use my time better on Thursdays and Tuesdays because time-lapse ones only take 2 hours from start to finish. So from the second I start drawing to editing and uploading, I could probably put it all out in 2 hours. So I think I need to maybe make a better effort with just working a bit harder with those. But the projects that I'm doing away from the camera are the graffiti stuff, as I said, because obviously I'll adapt, incorporate one of those, one of the live streams will be one of the, not live streams, one of the time lapses will be a graffiti piece. So I'm still working on improving that. The How I Draw series, so that's just like a little sort of guide, a little insight into how I come up with my drawings. I need to keep working on that. And there's digital pieces as well, specifically pixel art. So I need to make sure that I find time for all of it. Like, I really want to get stuck into the pixel art stuff. And there is, I mentioned a while ago on some social media that I was working on a book, which is true. I do want to get a book of drawings out there, but I kind of had to adjust. It's an idea I've had for so long to do a book. But the thing was, I maybe kind of rushed into it a little bit, is I had like an idea of what I wanted to put in the book, but it relied on digital paintings, but I hadn't quite sort of figured out the best way to do digital drawings. And I finally landed on, like I gave it a lot of thought, and I finally landed on just doing pixel art pieces. So when I start just refining my digital art skills, then I'll make a start on that. The thing is with the digital art, because there's two sort of types of book I want to do. The old type of drawing I used to do, it was like movie posters and movie characters. I actually did still want to pick that back up, but that was more with sort of digital brushes, and it was more sort of realistic. The style of it, and I tried sort of developing it as a more comic book style, and I do want to put a book out of sort of movie scenes that I really like, but that's a lot further down the line, I think. That is something I've always wanted to do, but I needed to kind of shore up this kind of these kind of drawings first before I did anything. Because I think that was the thing I needed to focus on. I needed to have a constant. So these kind of drawings, the ones that are quicker, that take, you know, only a couple of hours. I can I can turn these drawings into pieces that I can frame and sell. I can put on merch and stuff. That's a longer term goal. But I needed to start somewhere and start a bit smaller. I think the problem I've got is I think, oh, I can do all these things. It's like, well, no, just start small, sort of find out what you want to sort of draw, what you're comfortable drawing, what you want to draw first, and then you can expand outwards from that. So it's taken about a year to find out, or just about, well, it took about under a year to find out what I really wanted to draw. And now I'm starting to organize myself a bit better and, you know, put more focus in on certain projects and things like that. But as with anything, it just takes time. When did you put the work in, kind of thing? But I do think I look at some of the stuff I'm doing and think, yeah, you can do a bit more. I think because of the time of day I do this, I don't tend to really get many viewers on this stream, which is fine. Like I say, this series was very specifically for me to just experiment with live streaming itself, just to see how it would go. And to basically make sure I just don't waste supplies. Like, I don't know how many these pens that I'm going to use over time, so I thought, well, to make sure you get at least one good drawing out of each and every one of them, then it won't seem like a waste. And after today, we'll be 9 in. 120, 120, 111 to go. I think what I might do on a Friday is start earlier. I don't know, we'll see. We shall see. Well, I made a mess of that. Oh, my word. 5. I'll start putting the number in. Excuse me. Oh, bloody apples, look at my teeth. I've just realised looking up, and what I do with my drawings is I'll put the ID of every pen. So you can see it there. Is it showing up? Yeah, A105 is this one. But as I've looked up and seen it, it unfortunately looks like the word AIDS. That's not the intention. It is a number, an ident. And it's meant to say 1A105. I looks more like an O, thankfully, so it's like IOS, but you know what people's minds do. As mine just did then. I had no real plan for this drawing. Like normally when I do it, an artist one, I'll try and focus more on sort of what pattern or shape I'm going to do. Like I'll look at my cheat sheet and think, what can I do with this? But this one, I've just been like, nah, just draw it as if you're drawing something from that's in your black book, and I quite like it. It's a little bit harder with these drawings because I'm only using one colour. And they have been sort of yellows and oranges. But they've not been like super bright oranges, they've been more yellowy sort of oranges, so they're not most sort of vivid. Well, having said that, the last one, acid yellow, that was pretty good. That turned out a lot nicer than I thought. This one's not too bad. This is probably the most generic yellow that you can think of, I think. Which isn't a bad thing. I just always worry for yellows that they're not going to show up great. This one has shown up pretty good. I think when the colours start to get a bit more interesting, I might start adding a bit more like backgrounds and stuff. Well, I don't know. No, I don't think I would actually, because it'd just take away from the main drawing. Like I say, the fact that they are the same colour is what kind of messes that up. Ow. Obvious notice we've got a couple of people in. How are we? Hope we're all right. I need to find a better way to sit. I keep doing my back in. It's mainly to stop this stupid chair squeaking. Question is, how much of this space do I want to fill? I'll probably, because I didn't want it to be a just a block. I wanted to make it a bit more sort of interesting. The question is, how do I fill that space? I don't want to just completely colour it in. I wonder. There you go, something a little bit different, isn't it? Have a look at you. How are we looking? Let me drop this space a little bit more. look at you. This is a strange one, this. Because I quite like it, but at the same time, it feels like I've not covered enough. Might extend this out a bit. It's always that hard decision to think with these kind of drawings, because they're never it's never a set sort of amount that I do. It's just I decide when I think it looks finished. You know, it doesn't necessarily mean it has to fill every square inch of the paper, but I don't know. Sometimes I think, is it filled enough? Is there too much empty space going on? I don't know. Shit. Chuck my pen all over the place. Maybe blocking this bit a bit more. think I'm quite happy with that one. I quite like the unusual distribution of the shapes. Yeah, I quite like it. Think I am going to call that there. I better sign off on it. I can never know when. Sometimes when to sort of stop. Sometimes I think, do I need to do a bit more? Do I need to add a bit more in? But I quite like the sort of strangeness of the spread of that. But I shall leave that one there. That's episode 9 done. Lemon yellow. Oh, excuse me. I shall be back next Friday. I'll say on the day if I'm going to do a second one or not. The next time I'll be online, or I'll be live streaming, will be Monday. I'll do the Monday stream, and then I'll do a Black Book stream on the same day. Like I say, the weekend, I always say, Saturday's the day I always have off. I'm like, no, this is, do whatever you want. If you want to draw, then draw. If you don't. Although Sunday is a day, I've said this for a few weeks now, where I've tried to get our gaming channel back up. Well, it's always been up, but just contribute more to it. But something always comes up. Like this Sunday, I'm away all day on this Sunday, so I can't do it. I may do it tomorrow. We shall see. But for now, that's another Arteza drawing in the bag. Thanks to everyone who joined in. I always appreciate it. Any views, likes, subscribes, all that kind of business, always helpful. Been slowly ticking upwards, up to 192 now. The goal is obviously 1,000. A little way off that. But if I just keep grinding away, then hopefully I'll get there sooner rather than later. But again, thanks to everyone who stopped by, gave it a watch. I'll catch you next time.